As you've no doubt heard by now, Prince Philip passed away last week at the age of 99. For obvious reasons, the death didn't exactly come as a surprise, and sadly, the response from the British tabloid media was equally predictable. Yes, Meghan was blamed for Philip's death, despite the fact that she was thousands of miles away when it happened, and he was just a few weeks shy of his 100th birthday. Now, in a display of brazenness that's stunning even by the standards of the British tabloid media, the question of Meghan's attendance at the funeral has come to overshadow the story of Philip's passing and what it means for the future of the royal family. As soon as the news of the death was made public, Meghan found herself in a no-win situation. If she had attended the funeral, bad faith critics would have blasted her for blatantly disrespecting the Queen. In the end, she chose to stay home, and to the surprise of absolutely no one, a smattering of vile trolls criticized her for disrespecting the Queen by doing so. This, despite the fact that Meghan is pregnant with her second child and was not cleared by her doctors to make the trip. It's beginning to look as though Meghan's every action will result in further slander from the British press for the remainder of her life. But if there's an upside to all of this, it's that the funeral might provide an opportunity for Prince William and Prince Harry to make peace. The feud between Harry and William has been making headlines for years, and according to the British media, it began right around the time Meghan entered the picture. The official position of the British media is that all misfortunes that have befallen mankind in the past 5 years are the fault of Meghan, the 21st century Eve. Insiders say Kate Middleton is planning to help broker truce between Harry and William, something that might not be possible if Meghan were present. The rift between Kate and Meghan is even deeper than the one between William and Harry. One source tells the Daily Telegraph that the time is right for a settling of differences, as the two princes are completely on the same page for the first time in a very long time. They know it is not about them on Saturday, it is about honoring their grandfather's memory and supporting their grandmother, a royal source told the publication. I would be extremely surprised if that wasn't front and center of both their minds. They will be keen to spend time together as a family, in the same time zone for once, the insider adds. The entire focus is on the Queen. No exceptions. A family unified. As for Kate, sources have indicated that she's just as focused on the Queen, but she's aware that the best thing she could for Elizabeth at this point would be to bring about peace between William and Harry. Not coincidentally, it seems William and Kate are preparing to take their place as second in line to the throne. While this will not take place until Prince Charles is crowned following Elizabeth's passing, it seems arrangements are already being made. Sources say the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge have already begun preparing for their relocation from Anmer Hall to Kensington Palace. While it may seem, at times, that Elizabeth, who will turn 95 next week, is immortal, the death of her husband reminds us that that's sadly not the case. And Kate has been in the royal spotlight long enough to know that it's a bad look for a future consort to be taking part in petty feuds.